My name is Chris Collura, and I have been actively pursuing severe weather before I even had a driver's license in the mid-late to 1980s. I began chasing storms since 1986 and have purposely been in nearly 50 tropical storms and hurricanes since late 1987. Since then, I've been actively pursuing such storms during the Atlantic hurricane season each June through November. Over all these years, I've been in some of the worst hurricanes to ravage the Atlantic coastlines in history. So I prepared a list of my all-time favorite hurricanes. I documented it over 25 years of storm chasing. Some of these hurricanes may be familiar to other storm chasers, as well as any victims in their paths. Others may feel both awe and fear of nature's power. Prepare yourself for my personal top 15 picks of nearly three decades of hurricanes, counting down from the 15th to number one, and where it all happened, in this video entitled, My Top 15 Hurricanes Countdown, by storm chaser Chris Collura. We will start with hurricane number 15 in this list, and the first of our five runner-ups, Hurricane Andrew, Miami-Dade County in South Florida, August 24th, 1992. The third Category 5 hurricane in history to hit the United States, packing 165-mile-an-hour winds. Since the video quality back in 1992 was not all that great, we will include this as the first entry in this list.
And it is pretty impressive. Downwind.
Not count on it taking as long as it did. They said they thought, 3 or 4 days.
Yet to be confirmed as to exactly how much damage was done.
Wow, look at the street here. It's amazing. Total devastation. Trees down everywhere, everything destroyed. Look at the debris, the metal wrapped around the power lines here. This is incredible.
Number 14. Hurricane Irene. Coastal North Carolina. August 27, 2011. Coming in as a Category 1 storm, this storm caused extreme flooding and sporadic damage across the eastern part of the state. Out by one of the feeder bands. Number 13, Hurricane Arthur, North Carolina Outer Banks, 4th of July, 2014. Packing winds just over 100 miles an hour, this Category 2 storm ravaged the coastal areas and Palmetto Sound during the night and early morning hours.
I have a hurricane for the first time for all three of us.
Number 12, Hurricane Igor, September 19th, 2010. A large open water Category 1 hurricane moves across Bermuda and lashes the island with 85-mile-an-hour winds and storm surge.
Here we are, St. George, Bermuda, waiting for...
Number 11, Hurricane Florence, near Wilmington, North Carolina, September 14, 2018. This strong Category 1 storm comes ashore near Wrightsville Beach, causing wind damage and subsequent extreme flooding. Out of the five runner-ups, we are left with the remaining 10 hurricanes. Number 10, Hurricane Sandy, October 26, 2012, along the U.S. East Coast and brushing Florida. Although not a direct chase or intercept, the storm surge and wave action from the subtropical hurricane was the worst since the perfect storm in October of 1991. Number 9, Hurricane Jean, near Fort Pierce, Florida, September 25th, 2004. After Francis ravaged the area 3 weeks prior as a Category 2 storm, Hurricane Jean strikes the exact same area, destroying what Francis left behind, with Category 3 winds. Number 8, Hurricane Francis, near Fort Pierce, Florida, and battering the area with Category 2 winds for 2 days on September 5th, 2004, what chasers called the 48-hour hurricane.
Doug's gonna be taking Jason, I guess.
If it tightens up, we may not get it.
Hurricane number 7, Hurricane Ike, Galveston, Texas, September 12, 2008. This large and strong Category 2 hurricane had a storm surge rivaling that of a Category 5, topping the seawall and wiping out nearly everything on the neighboring Bolivar Peninsula.
water's a lot calmer here during the eye. This is in the eye of the storm, no wind whatsoever.
Yeah, some of it came on shore, got stuck, and then more huge tires.
Bigfoot ones in Orlando, yeah.
Number 6, Hurricane Irma, Marco Island, Florida, September 10th, 2017. This powerful high-end Category 3 storm made its final landfall on the southwest Florida coast after ravaging the Caribbean and Cuba as a Category 5 hurricane.
There it goes.
That thing's moving.
Gotta use paper towels to wipe this camera off.
Oh, Jesus Christ Almighty.
Get that brown color of the sky.
Oh, you got it?
Yeah.
All right.
There's the sun trying to come out.
Dead center. We made it right dab smack in the middle of that thing.
That was awesome. I'm gonna get that surge through here soon.
Best idea to get one here.
Hurricane number 5, Harvey in Rockport, Texas, August 26, 2017. This 130-mile-an-hour Category 4 storm came ashore near Rockport, Texas, causing extreme wind damage, only to weaken and drop over 5 feet of rain days later towards Houston, Texas.
I've never seen anything like this, man.
Yeah.
The
what's
whole
up?
Wall up there is, you can see it separating from.
For now, reporting live, we're going to report to KBRC Channel 2 News. Please back.
See stars overhead, so we're officially in the eye.
We're gonna have to move. We got about half an hour before the backside. Okay, all right, who else needs
rides? We'll use it for science.
Number 4, Hurricane Maria in southeastern Puerto Rico from Humacao to Caguas, September 20th, 2017. This high-end Category 4 storm tears across the island diagonally from southeast to northwest, causing devastating floods and damage. Power and infrastructure was disabled for nearly a year, after this violent hurricane, with over 3,000 people killed.
All for gas.
Number 3, Hurricane Katrina, between Gulfport and Biloxi, Mississippi. August 29, 2005, one of the worst disasters in the United States history, coming ashore as a strong Category 3, packing a storm surge nearly three stories high and killing nearly 2,000 people.
We're in the eye wall. Look at the surge coming into this building. Salt water can dump.
Ready?
No, not yet.
Hurricane number 2, Charlie. Friday the 13th of August 2004. Punta Gorda, Florida. Expected to be just a Category 2, Hurricane Charlie came ashore as a strong Category 4 hurricane during the afternoon in Charlotte County with the force of a strong tornado many miles wide.
Millibars, could you believe that?
We've got the second half of this thing. Yeah. A lot of debris flying through here.
This brings us to number 1, Hurricane Michael, Bay County in the Florida Panhandle, October 10th, 2018. This was only the fourth Category 5 hurricane to hit the U.S. in history since Andrew in 1992 at the start of the countdown. Packing winds of 160 miles an hour, it was the strongest hurricane in history to hit the Florida Panhandle, coming to shore around noon with a clear eye.
Blue sky up there. Stadium. Look at the stadium over there. This is incredible. Look at this. All right, the guy's moving away.
What are the winds doing that?
All right, we're on the backside.
I hope you have enjoyed this video entitled My Top 15 Hurricanes Countdown by Storm Chaser Chris Collura. Remember to not attempt hurricane chasing without proper knowledge or experience. For more information, be sure to check out my website at www.sky-chaser.com.